Hello, I'm Kevin Chapuis from Virtual Open System, and I will present the Secure Monitor firmware in order to enable mixed criticality system on ARMv8 architecture for multi-core hardware platform. An important trend in the design of embedded system is the integration of applications with different levels of criticality. As you can see on these pictures, the goal is to run a safety critical OS which contains different critical applications such as real-time, secure, safety, along with general purpose operating systems such as Linux, which contains virtual machine, virtualization extension. Such concepts bring new challenges. We have to ensure isolation of safety critical OS from memory, peripheral. We have to provide shared memory in order to exchange data between the different operating systems. We have to meet safety critical OS timing constraints for the real-time application, and usually real-time application or safety critical application in general request certification. If we apply this concept in an automotive use case, the goal is to isolate vehicle control, for example, the powertrain, the engine control in the safety critical operating system, and the connectivity part like infotainment system, V2X, V2V, in the non-critical application. We need to support different bus protocols because usually the engine control uses the CAN bus, and for the communication we use more Ethernet or most bus protocol. For the safety part, we need to certify the safety critical application. So the idea is to use computing performance and hardware capabilities of heterogeneous platform to centralize more functionality which have different level of criticality on the same hardware for cost-based weight and power consumption reason. So how we will apply this on the ARM architecture? So first let me introduce the ARM architecture. The ARM processor is split in two compartments, the secure world and the normal world. The secure world is totally isolated from the normal world access. We have the secure monitor layer. This secure monitor is always secure. It's the highest priority level, which provides a bridge to communicate between the normal world and the secure world. In the normal world, we have an additional layer, which is a hypervisor mode, which addresses the needs of device for the partitioning and management of complex software environment into a virtual machine. And on the normal world, as in the secure world, we have the kernel space and the user space. In order to change the exception level, we have hardware exceptions, such as normal and secure interrupt, and a set of instructions in order to call a specific service in a specific exception level. For example, we can use the secure monitor call to go in the exception level 3, it's the secure monitor level. All these exceptions are trapped in a vector table. This vector table is divided in 4 vectors. We have the synchronous exception for the services call, for example, the secure interrupt vectors, normal interrupt vectors, and the asynchronous data abort vectors. So the idea is to implement a secure monitor firmware in order to enable the co-execution of a safety critical OS on this side, which is certified, along with general purpose OS such as Linux KVM, which provide virtualization extension to run virtual machine. So this secure monitor firmware is running in the EL3 exception level of ARM architecture, and it will be developed by Virtual Open System. In order to exchange data between the normal world and the secure world, we will implement a shared memory, which is handled by the secure monitor firmware. We give the full priority to the secure world in order to meet the timing constraint needed for the real-time application. And finally, this secure monitor firmware will have a small footprint in order to mitigate the certification effort. For example, on automotive use case, we need to respect the ISO 26262 for the ASIL certification. So the secure monitor firmware has been designed by following this requirement. So the goal is to enable the safety critical OS and GPOS co-execution on the same core or hardware platform. The safety critical OS will be completely isolated by using the harm trust zone from the GPOS illegal access. The secure monitor firmware setup has to minimize the impact on the total boot process. We will optimize the interrupt latency between the GPOS and the safety OS context switching. And finally, the footprint will be optimized for the certification effort. So how the secure monitor firmware interact with the normal world and the secure world? So firstly, during the secure world execution, all secure interrupts are directly trapped in the EL1 of the secure world, so directly in the safety critical operating system in order to minimize the interrupt latency. As we want to provide the secure world running, the normal world only executes upon a request by the secure world SMC. We use a normal secure interrupt only to handle a potential secure world failure in order to retrieve if the secure world doesn't generate an SMC on time. During the normal world execution, normal interrupts are directly trapped in the EL1 of the non-secure world, whereas the secure interrupts are routed to the secure monitor firmware in order to forward it to the secure world as soon as possible. And for sure, the normal world can ask secure services through the SMC call to the secure world. So the secure monitor firmware architecture is split in four parts in order to ease the support of new hardware or new secure OS for the safety critical application and to ease the reusability of the software components. So we have the EL3 monitor layer, so it's implemented for ARMv8 architecture and it handles the context switch operation and routes traffic exception to the right handler. Then we have a secure OS dispatcher. It's an interface between the safety OS critical application and the EL3 monitor layer in order to dispatch, for example, the SMC service calls or the hardware exception. The platform API is used to abstract driver function call from the EL3 monitor layer, since this driver depends on the platform. On the hardware platform to access external peripheral. The secure monitor firmware will be fully compliant with different ARM conventions, such as the SMC calling convention, which define a convention for SMC in ARMv8 and ARMv7 to specify a partitioning of service provider to allow the coexistence of different vendors in the secure monitor firmware. We will support also the power state coordination interface, which defines a standard interface to handle power management in the secure monitor firmware. For example, this power control is used in the Linux ARC64 kernel. So the environment of the secure monitor firmware, the secure monitor will be compiled with the ARM compiler 6 for two main reasons. Firstly, this compiler is specially designed to optimize software running on the ARMv8 processor. Then ARM plans to fulfill requirements for safety development tools. So we could apply the ARM compiler 6 for safety development without further qualification activity. Then the secure monitor firmware will support several ARMv8 development platforms, such as the ARMFast model, which is the virtual platform, the ARM Juno development board, and finally the Renesas Haircar H3 board, which is a compliant board with the ISO automotive ISO certification, ISO 26262, as it'll be level. So to sum up, Virtual Open System is developing a certifiable secure monitor firmware on ARMv8 architecture. This secure monitor firmware will have a scalable software architecture in order to support new hardware platform and new secure OS for safety critical application. We will optimize the context switch in order to meet the real-time constraint of the safety critical application. This secure monitor firmware enable the co-execution of virtualized system and safety critical OS. The safety critical OS will be isolated thanks to the ARM Trust Zone hardware extension. And we will implement minimal change to GPOS and safety critical OS to run on top of the VOSIS monitor. So thanks for your attention. And if you have additional questions, you can contact us at contact@virtualopensystem.com.